Scientists here in Southern California are keeping their eye on Imperial County tonight after a series of earthquakes started this morning. They happened just south of the Salton Sea. Fox 5's Jeff McAdam joins us live near downtown to tell us what this possibly could mean for San Diegans. Jeff.
Hey, Kathleen, that's right. Well, geologists tell me that we had over a dozen earthquakes in Imperial County today. Most of them, though, so small, you probably didn't even notice if you're sitting at home watching here tonight. But what has scientists concerned the most is where exactly they're happening and what could happen next.
Here's the international border. So here's the Salton Sea. And you see these two red areas? Those are areas of the plate tectonic sense where the earth is pulling apart.
SDSU professor Pat Abbott knows a thing or two about natural disasters. He wrote the book on it.
Yes, I did. And still do.
Recent quakes in LA and North Carolina, and now this. He says the area just south of the Salton Sea has been known to release a flurry of small earthquakes from time to time. Out of the dozen or so on Monday morning, one as big as a 4.6.
It was a little, tiny little pulling apart.
But could it trigger something bigger? Last year on the 4th of July, the town of Ridgecrest, north of Los Angeles, was hit with a 6.4. Less than 36 hours later, a 7.1. Abbott says he hopes that's not the case this time around, especially because of where these smaller earthquakes are happening.
Right here, right near the tip of this red, underneath the sea, and here's the San Andreas Fault coming down right here, and that's where the San Andreas quits.
The San Andreas fault line split into three geographical areas. The section up north had its last major earthquake in 1906. The section in the middle, 1857. The one in SoCal hasn't seen a major earthquake since 1690. Some would argue we're due.
Usually they don't lead to anything. It's an event all by itself, and that's where it ends. So the odds are overwhelming that's what it is, but you never can discount. If it moves there from the Salton Sea all the way up through the San Bernardino city limits, that would be a magnitude 7.8 earthquake. And what that would mean would be San Diego would be moving northward. And so it's actually what we call strike slip, basically mostly horizontal movement. It would be the west side of California moving northward.
All right, so you heard the professor. Chances are we're not going to see an aftershock. If we did, that would happen within 72 hours. Next time that there is an earthquake at the southern end here of the San Andreas Fault Line, he says there's a potential for this San Diego area to move as much as 20 to 25 feet northward. From the Embarcadero, Jeff McAdam, Fox 5 News.